Good evening and welcome to Not The News. This is Simon Lane bringing you the latest from the Not The Disability newsroom. In Sydney, a delegation of orcs from Middle Earth has filed a complaint with the Human Rights and Equal Opportunity Commission alleging extreme vilification by hobbits. The statement of complaint from the orcs cited numerous examples of how the orcs were portrayed in Lord of the Rings. The orcs described themselves as a gentle, caring and sensitive people who were strong supporters of peace and democracy. Their statement claimed that their short stature and rotten teeth were no reason for them to be described as disabled little runts. In response, the hobbits filed a counter-statement describing the orcs as a mob of bloodlusting psychopaths. The hobbits themselves were then hit by a formal protest from the Mental Illness Awareness Council, which strenuously objected to their use of the term psychopaths to describe the orcs. The hobbits in turn accused the council of being orc-loving nutters. The human rights body has ordered a cooling-off period for all parties. The Minister for Miscellaneous Human Services has announced a $500,000 funding program under its scheme to get people with disabilities out of institutions and into the community. The new program will invite disability groups to apply for grants to hire specialist teachers to ensure that every person with a disability will be able to spell the word deinstitutionalisation. The Minister said this program was a brilliant example of the government's far-sighted initiatives by combining inclusion, literacy and independent spelling skills in the one program. A spokeswoman for the Minister rejected claims the program was inappropriate, saying that the ability to spell correctly was at the heart of community inclusion. The spokeswoman added that a planned future version of the program would teach people with disabilities to spell the word inappropriate. The announcement was made at a gala event with the disability rock group In Access performing the hit song, I Put a Spell on You. The AWB has lashed out at critics who have pilloried the wheat marketing body over fresh evidence of its kickbacks, the latest being to accommodate dictators with disabilities by providing information on kickbacks in alternative formats to standard print. An AWB spokesman said the company had bent over backwards to make sure that dictators with disabilities were not excluded from company services. The spokesman added that even dictators had feelings too. The comment drew a sharp protest from the Inside Outers, a self-help group of people with a condition of the spinal cord which causes them to be bent over backwards. The president of the Inside Outers said their members were sick and tired of their condition being exploited for cheap political gain from people who tried to link the condition to disability. According to the president, being bent over backwards was not a disability, but was simply a different way of looking at the world. The Commissioner for Invisible Disabilities declined to comment, saying there was no way anyone would not notice someone who was bent over backwards. And that's all we have for the moment. We'll be back later bringing you more from the Not The Disability newsroom. But for now, good night.